some change back. That all helps. So, those of you,
okay,
thank you very much. Those of you that have just arrived, there will be no class on the 4th of July because I'm in Birmingham doing my Tai Chi rehabilitation training. And I have to.
Doesn't seem like you need rehabilitation.
I don't need rehabilitation, but it's very useful. Hello.
We've only just started.
So, and then those of you that come to the earlier class, I think they'll be closing it over the summer break, but this class will still be going on. So we might be getting some extra people in it, which would be rather nice. And, probably end up, yeah, teaching for less hours, probably for about the same amount of money. But we may be moving over from September. I'm waiting to see what Jane says to Reach, which is the next town. village, metropolis, from that well-known city of.
What's it like? Going to city
status, yeah. Reach City. Oh, I love it.
Well, of course, it used to claim to be as important as Cambridge. If you have a look at the old maps, 16th century maps, Reach is written in capital letters as well as Cambridge.
Yeah. Well, that's very good. Is Ealing a city or is it a
city of Ealing?
It is a city.
Yeah,
it's got a cathedral. And is Cambridge a city or is it a
city? Yes,
a city. It's a charter.
It's
a chartered city,
apparently. Okay. Because I knew they were different, but it was, I can't remember. Because I get the history done of BBC Cambridgeshire and then. So we've had a few people sign up for the day retreat, which is on the same day as the Burwell Carnival, so not everyone wants to have fun, so that's really good to know.
Wants to have fun. You're still eating well then.
I know. No, it'll be very peaceful, so... Well, you might want to have peace instead of fun, so... Just and then open the arms. So yeah, I'll wait to see what Jane says, but I might just to kind of geographically distribute the Tai Chi around this area, it might be better because there's already, well, I've got my evening class which will still be here, but there's a class here on a Friday, Tai Chi class in the shoulders, so it might be worth just trying a different place and having two Tai Chis in Reach a week, see if that works. And relax. So just tune into your body. Just have a feet shoulder width apart, nice and relaxed. And we're just looking forwards as we listen behind. Just take a few slow, deep breaths. mind. So as the head, as you're suspending from the head, you're sinking your hips, and the hips are sinking back and down. Just really allow yourself to just sit in your posture. So when I used to do this with Master Chung, he used to call this sitting. Oh, let's sit. And then I'd get a bit confused because then he'd stand up. But it was just like, just really feel, and you've got this solid feeling under the feet. You wanna practice your soft focus gaze. So it's a soft focus gaze, so it's not just looking forward, you're also doing your peripheral vision, and you're also doing what you can hear. Yeah, I was really looking forward to seeing my teachers on Saturday, but they've gone down a bit, so they can't. They said, we're really sorry, we've had to cancel all our classes this week, we both tested positive. So I've got a phone up later to find out how that. Yesterday they just had a mild sore throat with no temperature, a bit of a cough. So fingers crossed and the scoopers will be okay. They've been like treble or quadruple jab, so they should be alright. But so I won't be able to pass anything on next week because I'll have to. Never mind. So we just whiz through the loosening, and then I'll suggest what might be a nice thing is we'll do a little bit of joint warm-ups, and then we'll go through the 18. Before we go through the 18, let's have a look at the tricky moves. So again, we're having more structure in the arms on these bits, a slightly stronger structure in the arms, just. Well, okay, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then change to that one. So there's a curve in the arm rather than a bend. Yeah, and then my friend from Japan sent me a recording of the frogs outside her house. Oh my goodness, it's fantastic. I'm going to make some music for it. That was really, really good. Because I sent her some of mine and Nick's birds. And she said, have some frogs in return for your birds. She's a sound recordist and plays trombone and composes. So she likes using nature for her compositions. So she was very happy to receive by email, a load of birds, single.
Yeah, imagine trombone and frogs.
Trombone and frogs would go great like Paul McCartney, wouldn't it? 3, 2, 1. But the moral of that story is noticing what you can hear while you're doing your Tai Chi. window open so you notice what's going on and you notice your environment. 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm gonna make the birds a little bit louder. Just practice your posture while I sort out the sound. Because they sound amazing.
I think we've got some evening birds. We've got some evening birds, dawn song birds. This is more dawn song, I think. Yeah, that's on full.
Yeah, plenty of birds when the cat's around.
Yeah. Yeah, wonderful.
So this is near Peterborough. That's what they sound like. He lives near a rivery thing, and he's writing a book about kingfishers, and he does a blog, the Kingfisher blog, and he films the kingfishes and records them and makes notes of what they're up to and stuff. And when he's not doing that, he makes sound recordings. I might send him the Japanese frogs, I think he'd like that. Yeah, if you want some Japanese frogs, I can put them on while we're doing our... Brilliant. They were amazing, I've never heard anything, it was just fantastic. Straightforward exercises. Check your posture. So the better you stand, the stronger the muscles around your back are. Yeah, it's quite interesting. There was on the radio this morning. Check out. They were talking to someone about there's a vote or something tonight, or something. And the guy that they were interviewing I was listening to the wren. I looked like, what, I didn't care. I was like, that's a really good wren singing. So see if you listen out for it. So it's been on the radio a few times. I don't know if it's been in the actual news. But they're interviewing this guy and there's this weird noisy wren in the background. So you can...
They're small but noisy, aren't they?
They're very noisy. So, yeah, let's... so you, there's a bit of a weight transfer, but it's mainly a circular movement. And we're just very gently easing into our lower back. Well, very well. Apparently there's a dentist in Burwell that played birdsong all the time, so I guess the Burwell people probably won't associate this with relaxation, but... And they go the other direction. Nice and small, check your posture, and we stretch up, and then we come over, one, come back, we come up, two, three, four, so nice. Oh, lovely. Okay, let's do bird folded wings. One. Open the chest. Two. Close. Open. Three. How close are you two to reach? Is it? So is it kind of equidistant from? Slightly more, okay. I'll see what James says. One more time. Posture again, pen, weighted wings, flying pen. All the ants seems to have gone. Yeah, in our previous class, an ant came to visit and was walking all over the hall, wasn't it? Amazing. And we can't see it, and we're hoping it's not because one of us has squashed it. No. So. So we did some recordings of woodlands. I think this might be the woodland one, possibly. And other side, and then also some evening song and dawn chorus. For the dawn chorus, he gets up at he gets there for 3 o'clock to set up. him takes a seat and then polishing the table. So we do monkey king takes a seat first. Not too enthusiastic, you know, so like a certain person was probably taking some seats, wasn't she? One more time. Start with your fingers, just wiggle the fingers. And then circle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other way, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Up, down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Shake, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Circles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Forward, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Backwards, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Over and under, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Shakes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, neck turn. Turn 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fantastic. And then semicircles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Great. Right. Any questions on that before we move on to doing the 18th step? Right. Just so you can have a listen. Let's see if I can find these frogs. Look at the download. Don't know if I've got them. Okay. No, I might not be able to find them. I'll have to find them another time, I think. Yeah, haven't quite.
things. Those are frogs.
That's not what I expected it to be, actually.
No, they sound like... That's... I think that must be the wind. Right, we're going to do the 18 set to some singing frogs. So she lives in Japan.
We're in Japan now. Listen to singing frog. Here we go. So we just start like this and we start going for it. I just thought I have got to share these frogs. They're fantastic. I've been really enjoying listening to them. We don't hear this sound in the UK. This one went and got a load of Japanese frogs and said, right off you go, chaps.
It was much longer than that. Oh, the other one's going. Oh, it's a frog and dog. She said it's frogs and dogs. Great.
But yeah, she called it frog and dog. So just notice what you're sensing. I'll put the birds back on in a bit. One time. And then dance the rainbow. Concentrate on this next one, parting the clouds. one more, and then we'll go to looking at the moon. Guess it's the frog gaze at the moon, isn't it? There's quite a lot of movements in Tai Chi that are to do with frogs anyway. There's the frog, swimming frog. So we can try that. So we can kind of, you know, empathise with our friends. How's he waking up to that every morning? More excited.
That's good, you say, quite quiet.
Yeah. It's an interesting one. Yeah. Just put the word in mind a bit of Arnold Rimmer. Four more, four, three, two, one. Scooping the sea, looking up at the sky. One more time. Bring the foot back, bring the foot out, and do it the other side. Keep breathing, very nice. One more time. Pushing waves. With the lifting the heel and lifting the ball with the foot, so we do it the way that the professor does it. Change. So forward. Sit back. Forward. Lift the heels. Sit back. Move the toes. Forward. Lift the heels. Amazing, isn't it? You know, it's almost symphonic, isn't it? With all the layers and softs, and then one solo. And matching the front steps. So he also does it like that, makes a little thing there and pulls that. That's what Mark does, so we better do that. Because that's what... It's on the rim again, isn't it? I don't know why. I think it's probably to give. It's probably good for the brain or something. And one more each side. Okay, wild goose flies. Rotating like a flying wheel. Oh, I think that again. Now that I watch the comedy show. And change directions. Good. Cool. I think they've got closer to their house, haven't they? That's a full on marching. Here we go. One, two, three. Okay, so it's that one and the rolling arms. Five. One more each side. Six. One more time. Great, okay, so that's the 18 set. I'm going to change back to the birds. Now we've listened to the frogs and the dog. Oh, the dog's back. I'm not surprised it's barking. They're making a right old racket. So, right. Back to the birds. I'll put the other birds on as well. There we go. So let's have a look. Okay, let's have a vote. Do we want to do bouncing ball while marching, or do we want to look at the basketball? Okay. So I think the important thing is if we just do it like this and just get the really like Japanese frogs and a Japanese dog. I thought it was very good. I'll send it to my friend Nick. Say, hey, check these people out. Amazing. I mean, I'd love to have actually gone to Japan when my friend Kaneko lives. But I could do a bit of frog spotting. Did you notice they had little rests, which I thought was very good, because in Tai Chi you're supposed to know when you can, when it's time to stop and when it's time to rest and to give space. And the other thing I noticed is every now and then there'd be like a little frog soloist, and it's quite, because in the Tai Chi thing they look at frogs and toads and think they're very wise, or especially toads, you know, because you've got, there was a hero who'd ride this magical toad, battle toad, that was like a battle toad that he'd go and, quite something, makes sort of Middle Earth look boring, doesn't it? So, we're just doing the bounce. So you've got the bounce as well, so when you do the step, go like this, and then there's a little bounce. You know, this would probably work better with reggae, wouldn't it? Notting Hill Carnival's coming up, so. Go to Notting Hill Carnival, practice your bounce of the ball while marching. I'm sure they won't think you're weird. So I have a hand like this, one, two, just without the stepping, we'll do it with a bounce, 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 big, little, big, little, big, little, big, little, big one, smaller one, bigger one, smaller one. We'll try that. Go a bit slower. And we're breathing. Right, and then the other side. So you can feel that. Okay, now we're going like this, and imagine you're a weather vane. Just turn like that. Have the knees pointing forward though, and we're just turning. Just turning. See where your arms end up. Keep your shoulders down though. Keep your shoulders down. That's it. And we're all breathing. Okay, then what we do is we combine those, and we get this. We go up, down, then turn, open, and we come back to the middle, come up, sink down, turn. So you want to keep your shoulders sinking, sink the shoulders, looking, listening behind, breathing. Breathe a bit more. Very good. Smiley. Yeah, you wanna be relaxed. So you can still relax. Fantastic. Okay, right. Now, magically, it's gonna transform into this harmonious, flowing excellence, which looks like this. So you'll do it just exactly the same. But isn't this simple? What could be simpler? Many things. But just give it a bash and just imagine, just make it soft, smooth, and slow. So I've reminded everyone that they're there's no class on the 4th of July?
4th of July.
4th of July, because I'll be in that Birmingham, that little village. So, in a hall with a bunch of other people doing Tai Chi and feeling really confused. It's great. It's so nice to... Yeah, I could have done it on Zoom. I am tempted to do it on Zoom. But then you don't quite get the same... And also, you can't chat to people. And
when you come back, you can only get them to take us.
Exactly. Well, I don't know what will be... what ones to learn, because we've not done any of the anatomy and physiology yet, but it's still... But I've already had to start using it, even though I haven't done the qualification yet, because of some of the brachial plexus injury I'm sorting out, so... quite fun. With the physios, by the way. They say, do that. Okay. So, nice and tall. I'm going to go back to this one. So, the trick to a lot of these movements, maybe not the stepping, but definitely the ones that involve any sort of a turn, is getting the waist mechanics working. So, getting the turning, and also feeling the ground under your feet. And when we're breathing, very nice. Relax around the jaw. Now, how does this feel from the beginning? Does it feel any different or
looser?
Yeah, definitely. It does feel looser for me, but it could just be, you know, I don't think it's just wishful thinking. So I think it's a thing because it's amazing how. I mean, you can see why the chaps in China and that, they'll be doing Tai Chi 7, 8, 9, 10 hours a day. And it's not, sometimes it can get quite strenuous, but a lot of the time it's very gentle movements, very mindful. So really, we should be doing it all day long, I think. And then everyone feels so much better. I was asking Marv about when he was in Malaysia and how many hours were they training. They were doing 5 hours of classes a day, and then on top of that they were practicing. So they must have felt wonderful, as long as they weren't doing too much tough stuff. And Sam Moore in Chichester, he was one of his Carole's top student, but he also trains with Chen Bing and Grandmaster Chen Xiaowang. He was training between 5 a.m. and 10 in the morning every day for years and years and years, and then teaching on top of that, so teaching from 10. So he was doing a lot, really, really excellent Tai Chi player. So the more you do, the better you feel, the better your body works. So notice what's going on. Okay, was it brilliant? Well, I'm glad you like the Japanese fox. Very good. Don't forget to hear that. Just breathe in. But I think. If I'm given the choice between frogs, dogs and birds, I think I'll go for the birds, if that's all right. But oh, that could be, yeah. He kept trying to record the cuckoo, but it was never close enough. It kept going further. He was very annoyed about it. And then one more time. And then... Embrace the tiger return to the mountain, but make sure your feet are just so. Just so. Breathe in. Breathe out.
Okay, better stop the video.
Fab.